Today I'm going to tie a Bob Quigley pattern called the Film Critic. It's an emerger pattern, and you know, Bob Quigley invented the Quigley Cripple. He also invented the Hackle Stacker, and this fly is kind of a combination between the two. So I'm going to start out, I'm going to tie on a Moonlit MLO 51, which is a size 14. This is a curved shank, 1X strong, 1X short, pretty stout hook. For thread, I'm going to use Semperfly's Nano Silk and Olive, and this is 18-aught. Really thin, really strong. It's also really slick, so sometimes getting it started on your hook can be a little bit of a challenge. I'm going to start it just a little bit behind the eye. Hold my waist piece off to a 45-degree angle, which will kind of collect all my wraps, one right behind the other. And with really slick thread like this, it moves it right up the shank and makes a nice uniform body. I'm going to bring it back just a little bit past the bend of the hook, and then I'm just going to take my scissor blade and just clip it off. All right, so this fly has a shuck for an emerger, and it also has a tail. So I'm going to go ahead and tie the tail in first. And for a tail, I'm going to use Coque de Leon. And being that this is not an adult mayfly, I'm not going to worry about having just three tails. I'm going to go ahead and just take a little clump. I want it to be a little bit shorter and a little bit bushier. So maybe, you know, 5-6 fibers, pull them off perpendicular, and then snatch them off, and now I have, my ends are pretty even. Okay, and then instead of worrying about getting this measured and putting it right on top of my hook, I'm going to grab it by the tips. So I'm going to go ahead and flatten out my thread a little bit, and then when I get my, I do my wrap, I'll get my tail fibers right up on top of my hook. Then I can take and I can pull the butts and get my length. Okay, so I don't want this quite as long as a dry fly. So that right there looks pretty good to me. And then I'm going to go ahead and just carefully wrap my butt ends, try to keep those right on top. And I'm going to wrap up to right about two-thirds up, so that'll be the length of my body, so about right there. Go ahead and get rid of the butts. Okay, so now I'm going to come back down, I'm going to flatten out my thread, spinning my bobbin counterclockwise, and I'm going to come down to right in front of my tails, right where they start, and now I'm going to put in some sort of shuck material. And so what I'm going to use is just some gray Z-Lon. Kind of a gray silver. Okay, and I don't really have to worry. Just a little clump, just to imitate or represent a little bit of a body shuck coming off. And same thing with this. I'm not going to, this actually I'm going to cut to length, so just go ahead and put it right on the side, couple of wraps, bring it right up on top. Okay, and I really don't, like I say, I don't have to pull this to length because I'm going to cut it to length. So I'm going to go ahead and take my butt ends. This will also give my body a little bit more girth, and then just wrapping right on a straight shank, and then I'm going to lift up my shuck material, and I'm going to come in with my scissors. I'm going to cut that at an angle. Okay, so that's going to be my tail. Clean this up a little bit. All right, now for a body, I want to go ahead and use a goose by it, and you can use, you know, whatever fly you're trying to mimic here. Your colors, you know, you can choose them to imitate, you know, anything from a PMD, a blue wing olive, any of the drakes. I have some brown olive goose by it here, so I'm going to go ahead and use this, and I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to tie this in. I want the ridge to rise up, so if I look at my biot, I want to put the notch side facing down or back. I'm going to tie the tip in right on my side of the hook. Tie that in secure. Throw a half hitch. Get my thread out of the way. A little bit of super glue. I can see some threads, and try to keep this fly as clean as I can. It has a lot of materials on it. Pretty well engineered bug, I think. So I'm going to use a little bit of super glue on my body here to give that biot something to adhere to, make it a little stronger. I'm going to grab the tip of my biot with my pliers, and then I'm going to come over. And I'm going to be real careful not to put any tension on this biot, just basically the weight of the hackle plier. Okay, and then once I'm ready, I can start to wrap. You can see that ridge is coming up on each wrap. I kind of like the way that looks. It gives it a nice segmented look. And I'm going to bring my biot right to where I ended my body materials, and then I'm going to take my thread. I'm going to grab just that front edge of that biot, two or three wraps behind, a couple of wraps in front, and I'm holding my thread up out of the way. Leave my hackle pliers, and then just come in here and cut. Okay, and then if I have anything sticking up, I can just kind of clean it up. So that's the body. Now, this fly has a wing bud, and it also has a front wing, or possibly, you know, it's like a post, so you can see this fly on the water. But it's all one material. So what I like to use are these are EP fibers. And they really, they seem to be a little bit more manageable than rayon and stuff like that, or so what I'm going to do is I need to form a loop here. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to marry my ends so that I have a nice loop. And the two ends I'm going to bring together, that's going to be my wing bud. Okay, and I'm also going to cut this so I can go ahead and trim up my ends just to get them square. Okay, and I'm going to put this right on top. I'm going to go ahead and wrap this right where my biot ended. Okay, you could do a pinch wrap there or whatever. Whatever you like to do to keep your material right on top. And I'm going to make sure, I'm going to come back with my wraps. I want to make sure that this is right where my last wrap of biot. Okay, that looks pretty good. And then I'm going to get all these ends. I'm going to come in, I'm going to cut this square and create a little wing bud. Okay. Now it's important that I keep this as a loop. Okay, and if I've got any stray fibers, which happens with this kind of stuff, go ahead and get those off now. And I'm going to hold this straight out, and I'm going to go ahead and wrap nice tight wraps all the way to just about maybe an eye length back from that eye, because I'm going to have to dub a head later, so I need to give myself a little bit of room. Okay, at this point I'm going to choose my hackle. This is some Cree hackle. I'm going to tie it in shiny side up. If you're wondering about the size, this is about a 16. Okay, so a little bit smaller than the hook that I'm tying on. So I'm going to tie it in butt first. So I'm going to strip off a little bit of, expose just a little bit of stem. And I'm going to just tie this in flat with the shiny side facing up. Okay, and go ahead and grab my stem. Wrap back right where my wing bud starts. Okay, and then I'm going to come back up. I'm going to grab my loop, make sure it's flat. And that first wrap, I'm going to try to compress all of this. I'm going to bring it back really, I'm wrapping really tight here because I want to really compress this. And I'm going to bring it back to where my wing bud starts, my biot ends. Okay. Clean it up. All right. Now, I need to put some dubbing on. I'm going to just choose some olive dubbing, some fine and dry. And I'm not going to build up a lot of bulk here. I just want to cover my thread wraps. So I'm not going to dub very heavily. It's just fine and dry and olive. I'm going to kind of pull it apart and get my fibers are a little bit long. Tiny little pinches. Like everybody says, less is more with dubbing, so I'm going to get it on there nice and tight. Okay, I think that'll do it. Now just slide your noodle up. Okay, now I want to get this right on top of my thread wraps. I don't want to get down by that eye because I'm going to put dubbing there later to stand up my wing and to finish my fly off. Okay, so there we go. All right, now this is an important part. So the way I'm going to finish off my hackle is going to be real similar to the way I do a parachute post. So I'm going to lift my loop, and I'm going to bring my thread in behind my loop and right on top of where that bud was. Okay, and then I can just put my finger in the loop, and I can bring my hackle around. And I want my hackle post to be about the same distance as it is from the post to the eye. I want to be pretty close to that, and I'm going to just take my time and bring it up nice and slow. If you find that your hackle splits while you're doing this, go ahead and just soak it in some water. Some hackle, I have some ginger that splits almost every time I try, and for some reason this Cree is it doesn't. So now I'm going to bring my hackle straight down back through. So it's kind of doubling the thickness. And when I get back down to the top of my fly, at this point I'm going to hook a hackle plier right to my hackle, not for any other reason than just weight. Okay? And at this point I can just let go of everything. All right, now what I like to do is I like to put just a touch of super glue right on my thread. Not much. And then I'm going to take my thread and I'm going to come underneath my hackle and above my body, just like I would on a parachute Adams. Okay. two, I think that's three turns. One more. So this is 18-knot thread, so it's not going to build up any bulk. All right, now at this point, I can take, come in and cut the end of my hackle loose. And if I see any hackle fibers that are coming down at this point, I can go ahead and come in and clean those up. Okay, it looks pretty good. All right, now I'm going to go ahead and my thread is olive, my dubbing is olive, so if I bring my thread up through, it shouldn't stand out too much, and I'll go ahead and just do a couple of wraps right around my eye. Okay, and get my thread out of the way, and then if I moisten my fingers, I can come in and I can stroke all of these fibers back. Okay, and so it'll take a few times, but when I get them all back, then I'm going to go ahead and bring my EP fibers over, and I'll go ahead and do one loose wrap, two loose wraps, three. I'm going to tighten up a little bit. Now I'm going to hold my bobbin tight, and then I can take and I can just pull. Sometimes you have to pull both sides independently. There we go. And that'll bring my hackle right up on top. Come in, do one wrap to secure it, and then I want to bring everything back and expose my eye. Kind of clean that up. Okay, now I'm going to dub a little bit of a head. And at this point, I like to readjust my hook a little bit to, being this is a kind of a curved down eye hook, I want to make sure that I get my eye kind of up in the air so my thread wraps don't fall off the end. It's a little better. Same dubbing as before, fine and dry in an olive. Like I say, your colors you can choose to imitate whatever fly you want. Change your size. And I don't need much dubbing at all here because I don't have a lot of room there. Mostly I'm putting a head on this, but I'm also, these dubbing wraps are going to push this EP fiber back and kind of stand it up. So I'm going to go ahead and start right behind my eye, and then I'm going to build forward or back up on those EP fibers without crowding. So I'm doing pretty tight wraps here. Okay, and there we go. All right, now to finish this off, you can either quick finish it or you can do a half hitch, which I kind of prefer because then I can make sure that my eye stays really clean. There's a lot going on up at the head of this fly. So I'm going to go ahead and do a few half hitches here. And with this nano silk, you can't really cut it with your scissors. So if I just open my points, push it forward, cut it off nicely. Okay, now I'm going to stand my EP fibers up nice and straight, and I'm going to cut them just a little bit higher than my hackle comes up, straight across. Okay, and then I can kind of flip my fly around here, and anything that's unruly or I don't like the way it looks, can clean up. You can see, you can't see my thread wrap come, or my thread come up through that green dubbing there. You know, at the bottom just a little bit. So that is Bob Quigley's Film Critic. Really good emerger pattern. It floats well, the back end sits nice and low. Like I say, I think it's a combination of the Quigley Cripple and the Hackle Stacker kind of all in one. So anyway, have fun tying it. Thanks.